we are here in the first installment of what we call the Co-op Mic. It's part of our project that we're doing with the European Union. The project is called Cooperatives in Development, People-Centered Businesses in Action. And what we're trying to do essentially is that we're trying to basically mainstream and visibilize cooperatives as an important force of development. But in order to do that, we need to reach out to more people. We need to bring the discussions on cooperatives at multiple levels. And so Co-op Mic is the initiative in that direction. We are essentially trying to broaden what we call the cooperative consciousness. Today, as part of our first installment, we have with us Dr. Gopi Ghosh. He's basically an inspirational speaker. He's a strategic consultant in agriculture, sustainable development, knowledge management, cooperatives, and creativity. His talk today stems from his long experience and exposure to a wide variety of cooperatives in India and abroad. So, I would request all of you to please put your hands together in welcoming Dr. Gopi Ghosh.
Everywhere in someone's life in India, right from the morning tea, you can have a tea, maybe produced by a tea growers association. Your sugar, of course, with sugar cooperatives. And likewise, the whole day, you have got a series of activities, a series of commodities that you will be in touch with, which has somewhere or other originated by cooperatives, which unfortunately we do not know. Essentially, so what is a cooperative? It's an autonomous organization, association of people who united voluntarily to meet their common economic, social, and cultural needs and aspirations through jointly owned and democratically controlled enterprise. So these are the red line are very important. These are the striking or unique characteristics of a cooperative organization. So cooperative, basically, you have shared goals. It's value-based and principle-driven, based on sustainability and participatory in its core values. It benefits the share as well, unlike the companies where the shares benefits goes to the people who own or who own the shares. The profit and dividend, even Amul provides the annual dividend, whatever profit they get, deducting the cost of development and cost of other costs, it has plowed back to the members. So basically need-based, that members get together to support program and community facilities for themselves, like housing or schools or any other activities. It fostered democratic traditions like social inclusion, continuing education, and improve practices so that they can improve their own lives and livelihoods. It's economic development, environmental protection, and social equity. These are all embedded into the system. So it's amply fulfilled, the qualified to fulfill the sustainable development goals. All the goals, if you analyze it, all these things falls under the three big pillars. But why cooperatives? I mean, why? We're cooperatives because there's an increasing domination of the big corporations. Even I was in Bihar. I do a project in Bihar with PwC, and that is small farmers linkage with market. And it's in Begusarai. They produce a lot of vegetables. And I said, why do you sell? So there is a middleman who comes here and buys it. And says, what kind of price you get? I was satisfied, but not at all. So, but why don't you do something? So we tried to do something. One day we tried to sell ourselves to the nearby mandi, and we hired a Trump Tempo and put our materials, and we went there. The moment we go there, there's a telephone call from this guy. So he talks to all these people. They said, don't touch this particular Tempo because he's trying to do things for himself. So his material got untouched. Second day also he tried, but nothing sold. So there is a complete exploitation. not only of big corporations, not only of authoritarian states, but also there are people around, there are forces around who do this kind of thing. As you know, there are disparities and inequalities and divides. Also, we have a rural urban divide, we have a illiterate, even we have a digital divide, we have a Bharat versus India, those kind of divides. So for these, to bridge the gaps, we need cooperatives. There is resource degradation scarcity, enormous amount of land and water and forest and other resources getting lost every day. And unless, and then also climate change is a big kind of situation. Climate change things upsets the whole. I think they are going to wipe the civilization, it seems, unless checked. And the whole lot of livelihoods options, the farmers crisis, for example, the small farmer survival is another question. A farmer with 1 acre or 2 acres of land, how can he fulfill his own ambitions, his education of his children, his disease, his own, it's not working. And then cooperatives did also for the giving the benefits of scale. That's what the small farmers with 1 or 2 kg or 10 kg of produce or milk, they cannot go anywhere on their own unless they get together. When they get together, they give the power of collectivity, the countervailing power to deal with the market, for example. It gives efficiency, it gives empowerment, because when such kind of people, Amul, for example, a woman who gives powers only 1/2 liter of milk, and she also feels, I mean, if you go there, she's a Maru society chair, it's my society. I mean, that woman, poor woman who gives only 2 liters of milk, she also feels that Amul belongs to her. But then, why, you can ask, why the cooperatives are not that much visible, they are not talked about? This is because of a couple of reasons, and this is a kind of generic world kind of level. This is basically poor understanding of actual and potential contribution. We have, we do not understand. I mean, ask anyone, a common people, when you go back, do you know Amul kya hota hai? They will ask that this is a company. Nobody thinks that this is a cooperative. So and if it happens to Amul, forget about all the other cooperatives, what is happening. Even IPCO and all other people do not understand. Even though it's IPCO, but then nobody realizes that it's a cooperative. Very people, except the initiated, the uninitiated, nobody. You know, common people have got very poor perception about the cooperative, their values, their prospects, and their potential. Cooperative is poorly communicated in terms of the processes it follows, what are the values, what are aspirations, what are its principles, of the problems it faces from the government, from kind of intervention that it has got, and from the progress, of course. There's a big problem of cooperative performance and their activities are not measured and documented, so it's not credible. So we don't have those kind of credibility in terms of even if you say, oh, cooperative has done things, oh, this is something. It's a propaganda. Nobody believes that. And that, when you talk about the next forum, there is a performance measurement of the issues, including the research and documentation of cooperatives. In some format, in IRMA and other organizations have started doing something, but I know of late, I do not hear much from them. Still a small part of GDP. So unless it could not occupy the mindscape of people and planners and development and researchers, that way that it should have been. So these are the another problem why cooperatives are not talked about. Laws and regulations are varied, often counterproductive, for example, ineffectual. Government should support cooperatives or should not support cooperatives, and there are issues, and that has got a bearing on the cooperative. And nobody from cooperative, they like to take money, they don't want to have control, but once you take money, the government has need to control because there's government money. So there are issues which needs to be talked about. And because of all this, they are deprived of required attention, idea, finance, support, talent, energy, enthusiasm. So what happens in India? Basically, is a neglect, interference, political. It's a poor professional and leadership. So success is more of an exception. Dilution, what I call cooperative sovereignty. Now, what is sovereignty? Your authority. Members have the authority to manage, to own, to see things for themselves. If that is gone, corporates are lost. A Balluram of Begusarai or Baharaj, whether he, with 1 acre land, whether he is going to cultivate, what will happen 5 years down the line? Is going to stay there? All he's plowing riksha after 2-3 years. What will happen to his children? I mean, we should think about these things. The poor people with resources, what are the kind of future we are going to give them? And that future can come only through cooperative. No significant revival, strategy or innovation. So structural weaknesses continue. I mean, there's no significant attempt to revive cooperatives. And it needs to radical change, radical thinking. Sustainability and climate change. Again, I said climate change is going to define our next course of actions, the way the things are coming up. The heat, the drought, the unprecedented amount of calamities happening, cyclones and those kind of stuff. And the vulnerability is going up, the resources are going down, the livelihoods are getting lost, and the risks are up again. So this is a kind of global phenomena. But this has got local solutions. And local solutions have to be done with people. All big people cannot change climate. All the effects are going to be on your... Impacts are going to be more on the tropics, more on the poor people. Yes. Rebuild research and technology transfer for better R&D, interdisciplinary adaptive trials, you do with farmers. Ultimately, you cannot have any other activities. I share huge apparatus and they should do with farmers. Some of the research so that they know what is the need of research. And this is called adaptive trials. And the farmers will give input to them. So we have got to give that kind of message that yes, it can work. Yes, there is Amul. Yes, there is IPCO. Yes, there are Lizard Papad. Yes, there is Seba. I mean, we need to have some kind of documentation to instill the confidence in the whole medium. That medium is such a strong medium. I'm still 100% committed to that medium. This is such a wonderful medium. It has got all the elements of community, common progress. But somehow it is not allowed to do it.
One question comes from Irma. A first year student asks, what is your take on farmer producer companies as a new form of cooperatives?
I'm all for it. When we started the Safal project, and Dr. Kurian gave this idea that if the cooperative registering and other things become hassle, why not to have something? So he only that spearheaded those things, and something subsequently in the Companies Act, there is a this Producer Companies Act came also. So it's a way out. Ultimately, I believe not only the word cooperative, but the whole essence of cooperative. And the essence of cooperative people getting together for their own common interest, working for themselves, that's what I'm for. That come in any format, it can be any format, but it has to be supported.
Policy deficit is one issue which I would like to highlight, not only at the local level but at the central and state level. There is a tremendous amount of confusion at both ends, and therefore cooperatives are stuck in the quicksand. One example is the loan waiver schemes which are offered from time to time, which have made cooperative workers, members dishonest, and therefore the rate of overdues in primary agriculture cooperatives has gone as high as 69%. People borrow, do not pay. Disappearance of consumer cooperatives. They are totally out of this circle. It has been taken over by the private entrepreneurs by setting up malls and others, no consumer cooperative stores. In the government offices, it used to be big consumer cooperative store in Delhi, finished, in Bombay, finished, in Madras, finished, no consumer store, only malls. These malls are selling what you are not producing. They are selling what other countries are producing for you. Where are the producer cooperatives in this country? What are they doing? Nothing. They are not producing anything for the market.
Now, my son was asking me when he has seen the match between India and New Zealand. There's a practice match, India and in New Zealand. And in the logo, they said, Amul, Papa, why this Amul logo in New Zealand player's jersey? So we have a success story. And our next generation, they are also coming to know from where? This is a cricket match between India, practice cricket match between India and New Zealand.
This particular talk is one of our initiative to see how do we have a conversation. I think people like Kukreja and others in this room have been in ICA for a long time, and they've been saying one of the reasons why cooperatives and the discussion is there was talk. We were having discussions. We need to engage with others. It's not just talking with amongst ourselves, but how do we bring others? And this is one attempt in that direction. And the ICA Domus Trust, the EU partnership and the ICA Domus Trust are the two hosts. And the Domus Trust has its origins in Dr. Maurice Bono. He was an international ICA president for a number of years. And his view was that cooperatives need to go to schools, cooperatives need to go to colleges, cooperatives need to go to university. And I'm thankful to Dr. Malika Kumar who's here. And I think colleges, if you look at the future, are, I think, where the cooperative future resides. And thank you very much for that. So we need to go out and engage. When I said, who's going to bell the cat? We need to bell the cat. One example, I'll say, now this whole IT industry is in a throes. You hear about job loss thing. And there's talk about forming an IT workers union. Why not IT workers cooperatives? Why not have a dialogue with them? Why union? Union is much more in terms of rights. You're fighting for your thing. This is more. No, we are working. We have a joint thing. There are immense opportunities out there. Value. Government talks about Swachh Bharat. Swachh Bharat involves people. How do you work in a... Until unless we work together, India is not going to be Swachh. It's not individual, but as a community, how we work. How have we positioned ourselves? India, the government talks about Skill India. How have we gone and got engaged with the government there? So, I think there's immense opportunity where we need to show where our values are. And do cooperatives need youth, or do youth need cooperatives?